試過沙士，所以我不想香港再次好像17年前咁樣樣。希望政府聽我哋的訴求，盡快將所有關口關曬去，令疫情盡快受控。
Today and yesterday in Hong Kong, there's an increase of 6 additional confirmed cases. As at 3 p.m. today, there are now 21 confirmed cases.
You know, I think we have to be aware that we could be in a similar situation right now with China, where the best and brightest are unwilling or unable to see, or some combination of the two, unable to see what's going on in China. But perhaps it's because they've invested so much in China, right? So you know, there's a thing called confirmation bias here, right? Where because they want it to be true, they will, because they wish it to be true, they will act as if it's true and reject data that argues the other way, data like the Tencent leak, you know, assuming that that's accurate. It sure seems like it is, because also, Steve, it's important to know Tencent didn't just do that once. They've done it several times now, where they release numbers that are far higher than the official stats, and then they're quickly corrected. So what I believe is going on there is their programming, their coding, just automatically uploads numbers, and then a human comes in and says, oh, wait a second, that's not the party line. I think also, Steve, it's important for us to think about the Chinese Communist Party. Just in terms of what's in their interest, right? It's not the interest of the Chinese people. It's the power of the Chinese Communist Party. And I believe they will do literally anything to try to maintain that power. And if you start from that premise sort of foundationally, then you really have to doubt everything they tell us about this coronavirus.
I think my message to you and to everybody is that has no impact upon what we're going to do for global health. I just want to be tremendously clear here that our responsibility is to patients, and our responsibility is to, number one, pursue the right clinical programs to determine whether or not this medicine has an impact with patients or not, and will be driven by the science, by the clinical evidence, and at the same time, ramping our production up in the event that it does, that we can get this medicine to as many patients around the globe in need. Patent is not at the forefront of our mind.
那从五号晚上的10点钟开始，位于武汉江汉区武汉国际会展中心的方舱医院正式启用，迎来了首批转运患者。
目前，由于这个方舱医院里面呢，现在是已经迎接了这样的首批和第二批的转诊的患者来，里面的可以说医护人员现在是正在进行非常繁忙的对他们的安置以及救援工作。江汉方舱医院呢，它主要收治的是这个轻微症状的这样的一个患者，如果是发现他们的症状一旦有加重了，那么将会及时对他们进行一个转院治疗。
还有个啊，还有是重症患者，我们不收，生活不能自理了，我们也不收。走路走不了了，生活不能自理，这不是医院，这是个隔离点，出了事没有任何人对你负责，我们也担不起这个责任。这只是隔离点啊，跟大家说，强调过很多遍，这不是医院。你来了就只能在里面安心医的进行隔离，而且不能出来。
如果说妈妈要打针怎么办呢？
那也解决不了，因为我们这没有任何一些救助设备。最主要一点就是说，这里你进来了就不要再出来了，避免进行一些交叉感染。家属也是一样的，不要进来，它就是个隔离点。如果说接受不了啊，你们这边就可以回家自行进行隔离，都是怕那个怕感染。来，第二个。
给你们看一下方舱的样子，这就是方舱，就纯是这样的，每个人中间的距离应该是1米左右吧，就关在这里， 什么治疗也不。
这就是所谓的开水房，只有一个开水房，没有洗澡的地方，洗漱的地方都没有。这就是所有的人，全部都睡在这个地方。根本都没有隔离，一个隔离间都没有。这么多人，你说要洗漱，要上厕所，到现在早餐也没有，医生也没有，就只是登记登记，就登记了恨不得三天了，就没一个医生过来。还有，到处都是。我先进来的还有一个床铺，后进来的全部铺在地下了，在地上睡。就是昨天晚上12点钟把我转到这个地方来，怎么叫什么方太还是什么部队，所谓部队的那个医院里面又没有厕所，又没有药吃，又没有开水，上厕所还要在外面200多米以外，外面下着大雨，本来走完进了医院好了的，这还搞拐了，全都是这种病人，恨不得还要感染。这是什么方太部队所有的那个医院，这么多人，这怎么看呢？这互相感染还吓人些，又没药吃，又没针打，全都是这样子的人，有的甚至比我还重一点，到处都是的，又没隔离，就这一个板子，而且那边都是人，这都是的。一在红山宾馆里面就这么捅扑，又没隔离，又没厕所，开水还要走到那个地方去打。